Well, first, Wolf, thanks for having me on. It's a pleasure to be here. You know, the governor has always been very deliberative when faced with very difficult policy decisions. She's had a history of, since she assumed office in 2009, of dealing with very difficult issues, from one of the worst budget deficits in the country to the immigration discussion in 2009 and 10 that continues on to today. And so this is familiar territory with her. She will take her time. She's been in the nation's capital with some governor's meetings. She's on her way back to the state today. I presume she will meet with supporters of the bill to hear their cause, meet with people who have expressed their views in opposition, and also meet with legislators who have subsequently changed their mind after the vote. And so I would expect her to make a decision sometime Thursday or Friday. But she'll be very deliberative in the decision. She vetoed a very similar bill, if not nearly identical bill, last year. Funny how much attention this one's gotten since she took that stance last year. And all of those reasons why she vetoed it last year are relevant today.
So presumably she'll go ahead and make that same decision. She's under pressure from both Arizona Senators John McCain, Jeff Flake. They both are suggesting this is not the right thing to do, to sign this legislation into law. They're deeply concerned about the economic impact on the state, because presumably tourism, which is so important, as you well know, in Arizona, could be impacted if this legislation became the law in Arizona. Is that right?
Yeah. First time the state's been in this position. I had the opportunity to be one of the people who was running the first Martin Luther King campaign out here. Eventually, Arizona became the only state in the nation to actually vote on a Martin Luther King holiday and pass it by popular vote. And so, you know, we're used to these. You know, I'm fond of saying we're the 48th state admitted to the union. Sometimes we act like that. We act like the adolescent child, which is sometimes pretty good. We get very vigorous debates out here on various issues express a wide variety of opinions and have a vigorous discussion about them. And throughout her tenure in office, she's been fortunate or unfortunate to be part of many, many of those discussions.
And if she vetoed very similar legislation a year ago, I would have guessed, and I assume you would as well, she'll veto this legislation, right?
Well, I never guess what the governor will do. I'm pleased that she's allowed me to talk to her about this issue. She's always a very open person in terms of talking to folks and hearing them out. And that's all we can ask of folks that are our elected representatives, is that we're heard. I did convey to her my thoughts about that, and that my concerns were that we have, you know, 50 statutes on the books in Arizona that protect religious liberties in Arizona. We all know we have our First Amendment of rights as well. There's a whole statutory framework for that currently. My personal concern on this one is it's just written, and if you look at all the other statutory makeups, it's much too broad, and it could be construed in very unusual or different ways and cause havoc on the system here in the state. I was fortunate as a young kid to have my father argue a case in front of the Supreme Court, which in 1971, Dewey versus Reynolds Metals, which was a First Amendment case about a Seventh-day Adventist who refused to work on a holiday, on a religious holiday, or have anybody else work in his place. That was an interesting case. I was a kid at the time, but we still debate these types of issues in our country, and she's at the epicenter of that debate right now, and I'm sure she'll take a very thoughtful approach to it with her staff and her team. And as I said, I believe she'll make up her mind sometime Thursday at the latest on Friday.